إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
حديث البطاين طب حديث لمقدمة ابن الصلاح رحمه الله تعالى and last time we stopped and we spoke about the hadith الصحيح the authentic hadith الحديث الصحيح and I will promise the hadith صحيح إن شاء الله رب العالمين I will classify the hadith and make it simple and easy for us to understand it in the future إن شاء الله to be expert إن شاء الله to be expert when you have the hadith to classify the hadith and say that the hadith صحيح This has to be ضعيف immediately, inshallah. And let me go to another siga, siga that means another way of hadith in the meaning of the hadith sahih in order to understand it. We have it in the salah, and we're going to have it that also again, but the same way, in the same meaning, but different way. The same meaning, but different way. All right, so we agree about that, and inshallah, the end of this class today, We'll understand the conditions of the hadith to work in this category of the hadith, inshallah. The other siga or the other way of the hadith al-sahih, I'll read it in Arabic for you, and then I try to translate word by word in order to understand it, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. See, هو الحديث, الحديث الصحيح, هي هو ما اتصل إسناده بروايتي عدل تم ضبطه عن مثله إلى منتهى ولم يكن شاذا ولا معللا almost the same way the different here say what ما اتصل سنده the chain of narration the chain connected the chain of narration connected one by one by one connected and this connection عن عدل the condition of this chain عدل and ضابط عدل and ضابط عدل just fair we're going to speak about today also more and ضابط actually in memorization we're going to speak about this more today also and he repeats it again عدل ضابط ابن الصلاح عدل ضابط عن عدل ضابط he repeats it again but here in the another meaning different علماء different scholars say similarly similar than the عدل ضابط عن مثله similar than the first one you understand me here so عن مثله إلى منتهى إن لم يكن شاذ ولا معلل there is not شاذ defect or شاذ or irregular we're going to speak about this those five conditions we're going to speak about five conditions number one condition الاتصال الاتصال the connection الاتصال right now this inshallah does everybody have a trouble in the audio everybody have a trouble in the audio or only Imad okay Imad this is the problem with your phone Habibi inshallah anybody have a trouble other than Sarah didn't know anybody have a trouble No. Okay. So number one, الاتصال. الاتصال. That in the way of Arabic, the way we pronounce it, الاتصال. Okay. So the connection. And what is that? The connection. Give your attention please to the connection. هو سماع hearing سماع الحديث the hadith. لكل راوي for each one in the chain of narration for each one in the chain من الراوي الذي يليه so هو سماع you hear from one راوي the one reporter of the hadith one of the chain to the second one to the third one to the fourth one to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم So hearing, the condition here we talk about hearing. He hear the hadith. It's not only hearing from whom. This is the condition from the person in person. You hear it in person, not I heard someone so and so saying so and so. No, you hear the person in person to person, face to face, face to face. That's an ittifal. ويعرف الاتصال بأحد أمرين. Please give me attention to this. We know the connection in one of the two ways. The connection from one of the two ways. Try to write this down, inshallah. It's very important. We know the connection in one of the two ways. أن يصرح الراوي بأحد صيغ السماع. If the Rawi, the reporter of the hadith, he has to give you one of these terms. One of these terms. What are the terms? حدثنا. You see that in Sahih Bukhari or Sahih Muslim. حدثنا. That means he told us. حدثنا. He spoke to us. He told us. حدثنا. أو حدثني. Or spoke with me. حدثني. Spoke with me. أو أخبرنا. He told us. Or أخبرني. He told me. He told me. أو أنبأنا. أو أنبأني. That means person to person, not everybody here. Person to person, he told me the hadith. Person, أنبأنا or أنبأني. أو سمعت or I heard. أو قال لي, he told me. قال لي, he told me. أو قال لنا or he told us. He told us. Those terms, you look at any book of hadith and you find one of these two terms, one of those terms. So the connection again, one of these two. This is number one. Number one, again, حدثنا or حدثني or أخبرنا or أخبرني أنبأنا or أنبأني سمعت, I heard, or قال لي, he told me, أو قال لنا, he told us. This is number one. How many of you opened the book like you heard it down? Send it to everybody. Say, how many of you, when you opened the book of the Ahadith al-Bukhari, for example, you find these terms? Tell me, how many of you heard, you read that in the حديث البخاري أو المسلم أو أي book of the hadith. How many of you? No one writing anything. You never opened Bukhari in your life. You never opened Bukhari or Muslim or Tirmidhi. Okay. Yes. Have you heard about those terms? Have you heard about those terms? You have seen it only, but you didn't read it. You read it. Then at least students, have you ever opened Bukhari or Muslim and you find those terms, even if that translation in English? Tayhana, Imad, Aisha. You read those terms, yes. So those terms, okay. This is one of the connection. I will proceed, inshallah, because you find it. If you never open it, I want you to open it. I want you to go al-Bukhari al-Muslim and I want you to read it. I want you to open it and read it and see those terms about the connections. Let's do number two. Let's go to number two in the connection. أن يأتي بصيغة, one of the terms, تحتمل السماع أو غير السماع, كأن يقول راوي قال أو حدثه. One of the terms, he said so and so, said such and such. So and so, said such and such and such. Alright? Or Rawa, or he told the people so and so, or he told the people such and such. أو ذكر, mentioned, or so and so, mentioned such and such. He belongs the hadith. There's another way of the hadith. You, inshallah, have the Bukhari online or you have it home. open the book of Bukhari or Muslim and you'll find these conditions. When there is, give me your attention, this is statement also again, when there is a connection between the chain of narrations, there is a connection, then we take out المنقطع, that means the hadith cut off, المعضل, the difficult, you just write it down, you're typing down, or المعلق, the pending, or مدلس, that means some lies, or مرسل, I mean that it's cut off somehow. So if there is a connection, that means impossible, there is weakness in the hadith. Connection. With the connection, what is the two conditions? Adil and Dabit. Adil and Dabit. And let's come to second, that is condition number one for the hadith of Sahih al-Ittisal. If I ask you in the exam, what are the conditions of al-Hadith of Sahih? What is the condition of the authentic hadith? You tell me five conditions. Number one, al-Ittisal, the connection. And the connection comes in two ways. As I mentioned to you, number two, al-adala, adl, just, fair. And let's understand what exactly al-adala in the linguistic translation, al-adala, just unfair. Just unfair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-adl. Allah al-adil. Allah al-adl, and Allah what? Al-adil. Now here in the hadith we have adala, adl also. I can be just also unfair. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with alif lam, al-adl, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. What is al-adala? It is sitra. Fitra, that means nature, in within the soul of the person, in within the person, fitra within the person, making that person present himself to do a great sin, or insist to do minor sin, or any of the honor or dishonor things. Dishonor things. Again, al-adala is the fitra. It comes with us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. If you open Surah al-Rum, ayah number 30 in Surah al-Rum. Write down this ayah. In part of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فطرة الله الذي فطر الناس عليها لا تبديل لخلق الله فطرة الله إذن فطرة that الله سبحانه وتعالى has created us with that فطرة الذي فطر الناس عليها and there is no way to change the فطرة of a human being so الله سبحانه وتعالى created us with his فطرة with the فطرة and this fitra come with the person, within the person, and preventing that person to commit a great sin, or insist to do minor sin, all the time, and anything to dishonor that person. That is al-adala. That's condition number what? Number two, those. Number three, ضبط number three ضبط عدل ضابط فالإذن الصلاح عند الجنة عدل ضابط عن عدل ضابط here عن مثله that means you repeat it again number three الضبط the accurate what does that mean I see the person and I can describe the person that person white or black, descended from Arab descent or non-Arab descent, blue eyes, green eyes, red eyes, whatever the eyes is. And so I described the person in accurate description. Here, accurate listening. Accurate. Whatever you said, I can transfer this to the other person, exactly the same thing. So, adopt the accurate here. And the person always aware, have the awareness within the person. Awareness within the person. All right? And that makes the person, whatever he hears, he transfers that to us exactly the same. The same. And there is no way to play with the word. No way to play with wording. That is adopt. That accuracy he can describe. And he can tell you, I heard the hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was sitting and his hand in the floor or his leg, one leg up and one leg down, and he can describe exactly where there is a mountain behind the Prophet or he was on the camel or riding a camel or anything like this. So this is accuracy. We're describing the person. We're speaking about you. Hadith sahih, remember. When we speak about hadith sahih, this kind of accuracy with description and meaning exactly the same thing. Okay, I think you're getting the notes what the Sister Annie writes for you. It's very important to type this also to write it back. Type this. It's very, very important. Very important, please. This is condition number three. Condition number three. And in condition number three, we said, I think last week or last time, the doubt, we have two types of doubt. Two types of accurate. Or accuracy to the person, accurate with his listening. We have two types of the ضبط. ضبط الصدر وضبط الكتاب. Remember these words. ضبط, the accurate of صدر, memorizing. صدر that means chest. But we mean the chest is the heart. I memorize the hadith with my heart, not my brain only, my heart. And ضبط with the accurate writing. Writing the hadith. And we spoke about this, but let me just like remind you with that, inshallah. We said doctor الضبط أن يكون الراوي حافظا عالما بما يرويه. Since the doctor, the one having reporting the hadith, he memorizing the hadith, comprehending the hadith, and telling us the hadith exactly as he heard it from the Prophet or the Sahabi or the Tabi'i or anyone else. Okay? So, and then there is no way to make any kind of changing in wording. No way to make any changing in wording. And why? Those people, they are afraid. Because of the hadith of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said, من كذب علي متعمدا فليتبوأ مقعده من النار. Whoever makes lies and with intention, he have a spot, a place for that person in hellfire. Why is that person in hellfire? Because he created Sharia, he created a religion. That's why the words of the Prophet is Sharia for us. Sharia, that means deen, religion. And no one can play with the wording, whatever the wording is. You have to describe it as is or be silent. Don't speak anything or don't say anything. Alright? So, and those people, they understand that very well. The Sahaba radiallahu alayhim and the Tabi'een and the Tabi'i Tabi'een. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them, big reward, the Jannah with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because they brought the hadith for us in a very beautiful manner and a very beautiful way. And we have also حفظ الكتاب, writing, memorizing or writing, and now I discuss this and say, which one is better? In the person memorizing in the heart or writing the hadith by in the book? Which one is better? Please, Imad, which one is better, to memorize the hadith in the heart? In the heart. And he said, in the heart. What about Aisha? In the heart or in the book? Anybody else? In the heart. In the heart, okay. Heart. All right, Aisha, why not? Aisha, why? In the heart. MashaAllah, all of you in the heart, and I agree with you. I agree with you, it is in the heart better than write it down. Why? Aisha, you are writing something. Because no one can... Very good. JazakAllah khair. Very good. Because no one can touch it or change some wording in it. But you have it in the heart. But while also, you can have it in the heart and writing down the note. And you know exactly what is in your note. You know exactly what is in your note. That's beautiful. That's very beautiful. You know, I advise all of you, brothers and sisters, at East Institute or Sunnah Forward students, always have pen and paper with any lecture. That's why my shiyukh, and believe me, you always remember what you are writing. Even if you memorize in the heart, but the book will remind you more. So my advice to you, life is short. Always have a pen and paper when you read any kind of lecture. Any kind of lecture, even lecture is not even in the curriculum. Regular lecture, write it down. You will get treasure in the end. InshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our knowledge and increase your knowledge, all of you, and make this subject and all the subjects easy for all of you, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather all of us in the Firdaus al-A'la with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Now, let's come to the condition number 4. Condition number 4. Adam al-shadud. There is no... What is shadud? Shad. What is shad? What is shad in English? Irregular. No irregularity. That means shadud is abnormal. Irregular or abnormal. That's condition number 4 in the hadith sahih. And that is shad or shadud or irregular when the person bringing something different than what he heard in or learned. Different than what he heard or listened or learned. Okay? Or we have two people they took the hadith, and two people they brought the hadith, and one of those people he have a different, and he brought the hadith in different way, different terms, different way and different terms. Okay, let's take an example. Well, let's take the example in the end, inshallah. The examples we have in the end, because let's go to the condition number 5. There is not mu'allan, deficiency. There is no deficiency in the hadith. وهو أن لا يكون معلما في أي لا يكون فيه أي علة تقلق في صحابه. There is no deficiency. So something in the hadith made the hadith completely irregular. And we're going to speak about this in hadith ضعيف more. We're going to speak about hadith ضعيف more about معلل and شاذ in more details, inshallah, رب العالمين. Inshallah. Okay. العلة or the deficiency, we don't accept the hadith. There is deficiency in it. Why? Because either that hadith منقطع, disconnected, ينقطع هذا من ديسكونكتد وموقوف جينيتيكال ديس موقوف هانجينج بيندينج ان حديث ضعيف جينيتيكال ديس نو ديتيل ان شاء الله وراوي الراوي الساسق ساسق او ساسق مثل ديسوبيدينت او ذات بيرسون سيء الحفظ his memorization is not good كانت memorize very well كانت memorize very well or مبتدع was مبتدع مبتدع is the word كمان making بدعة innovations so بدون accept this حديث because this حديث ضعيف or sometimes this حديث fabricated حديث والعياذ بالله let's take some examples for حديث there is علة in the حديث علة or deficiency in the حديث or حديث شاذ let's take حديث حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما ابن عمر بن عبد الله بن عمر دفن أبو عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه وعن أبيه رضي الله عنه وعن أبيه سيد لا تقرأ الحائض ولا الجنب شيئا من القرآن في بالضمن الحديث من deficiency in the حديث لكن الحديث ضعيف is weak حديث but why weak learn why this حديث is weak Okay. That reported by Tirmidhi. This hadith reported by Tirmidhi. And this hadith came from a person, his name Ismail ibn Ayyash. And also came through a report by his name Musa. Musa ibn Uqba. So, according to the people of Al-Hijaz, the Arabian Peninsula, Ismail ibn Ayyash, that person, he don't have a good memorization. He do not have a more good memorization. That means, in the hadith, there is deficiency in the hadith. He is saying that, and he combined the woman when she has a menstruation monthly period, and he said the woman, and also the junub, after intercourse, she cannot read anything from the Quran. That means he combined between the woman when they have monthly period and after the intercourse and combine it together. Okay, we say this hadith is weak hadith. Because in this hadith, not because the wording, no, because in the person is weak, the person is don't have a good memorization. He just assumed the hadith at the way they heard it from the Prophet. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alright. That illa that means deficiency, something that shaz, irregular, بفعل ما رواه عبد الواحد بن زياد reported by عبد الواحد بن زياد قال حدثنا الأعمش عن أبي صالح عن أبي هريرة he said حدثنا بن توقف الأعمش ومن تبع التابعين عن أبي صالح أبي صالح والتابعين عن أبي هريرة صحابي ريبورت صحابي قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس كيف في سنه إذا صلى أحدكم ركعتي الفجر فليضجع if you pray two ركعة فجر you make him ضجع إذا you put your hand under your head over your arm and you lay down until the fard to feel after the tishunna You see, this hadith irregular. Why this hadith irregular? Because this is the description of the Prophet. He does the Prophet ﷺ. He does not say that the Prophet ﷺ. He did that. The Prophet ﷺ. He did that. But those two tabi'in, tabi' al-tabi'in, they brought the hadith from Abu Huraira. And Abu Huraira, he doesn't say that the Prophet ﷺ said so. He described. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He described the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That means his description not order from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he reported as an order. And we say this hadith irregular because this hadith supposed to be, and this is reported actually in Ibn Majah and Nisa'i. And we're going to speak out more about Shaykh al-Mu'allam, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. We're going to think more and more about this shad al-mu'allal, inshaAllah. So, whatever we mentioned last time and today, that is hadith sahih لذاته. That means the hadith itself, for itself is hadith sahih. There is hadith sahih لغيره. Hadith sahih, because another hadith is supporting this hadith. To raise the hadith to hadith sahih. Again, that hadith is not sahih. Not sahih. But then we find hadith similar, supporting this hadith, raise this hadith, the rank raise it to hadith sahih. That means it is not sahih, it's hasan. Or meaning less than hasan. But we find another hadith similar, then this hadith will be raised up to hadith sahih لغيره. We say لغيره because the another hadith, it is sahih, and this hadith becomes sahih. It's not sahih anymore, it's not hasan anymore, become the hadith sahih because similar a hadith supporting this hadith. Okay? And that also some scholars, they consider this hadith sahih لغيره, that means hasan. Sahih? The hadith لغيره because for another hadith, we consider this hadith hasan. And the way hasan the thing is good. The thing hasan, it is good. What is hasan? Is hasan the thing beautiful? When you say the what is the meaning of hasan, please write hasan, hadith hasan. That means husn. Husn, that means jamal, beautiful. That means good or beautiful, that is the in Arabic language, hasan. So, wajhul hasan, that means beautiful face, not me, someone else. So, beautiful face. So, that means, istilahan, the term, the Islamic term for that, since ta'rif al-hadith, hadith annahu mutawaffiq ma bayn al-hadith al-da'if al-hadith. That hadith is not da'if, but not hasan, not sahih. In between. It's not weak, it's not strong, but in between, that is hadith hasan. And of course, the Sahaba, the scholars of the hadith, the tabi'in, tabi'in, the scholars of the hadith, they classify the hadith hasan, that means good, and they take it in all matters of fiqh. They take the hadith hasan in all matters of fiqh. Okay. Because you are a student of knowledge, I will join and share with you some other things, is not in your book, you know, but similar in your book, but for you to know all the aspects. Okay. What the other scholars other than Ibn Salah, give me your attention please. Other than Ibn Salah say the terms for hadith hasan. And believe it or not, the best of the ahadith, hadith hasan, the translation or the meaning of the hadith hasan, the meaning of the hadith hasan by Ibn Salah and Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, rahimahullah. Ibn Salah al-Hajar, let's say this hadith. What is Al-Hafiz, one of the names of the scholar of the hadith, his name Al-Khattabi. Umar ibn Khattab, but this is Al-Khattabi. And what is the name of that person? The whole name, you hear it a lot. If you study the science of the hadith, you hear Al-Khattabi a lot. His name, Abu Sulaiman, the nickname Abu Sulaiman, and his name Hamadi. His famous name, everybody calls him Al-Khattabi only. He was born in 317 Hijra, and he died in 388. And one of the very famous book for Al-Khattabi, rahimahullah ta'ala, called عالم السنن. One of the very famous book and this book is a great book actually for the science of the hadith called معالم السنن, the clarification of the sunan. What he said about the hadith Hassan, he said هو ما عرف مخرجه واشتهر رجاله وعليه مدار أكثر الحديث وهو الذي يقبله أكثر العلماء ويستعمله عامة الفقهاء. He said هو ما عرف known, the hadith Hassan is known from where comes from where, from what sources, what the resources for this hadith. He said when it is known that the resources, it's known. And he said, and the narration of the hadith, the narration of the hadith, they are famous. And he said, the majority of the scholar of fiqh accept this hadith. Let me answer with you. A lot of scholars of fiqh or the hadith, a lot of scholars of the hadith not accepting this term very well. And that's true. Why? Because we know the resources from different places, but sometimes it's weak. Sometimes it's weak, and sometimes say, and it's not conditioned for his men or the resources to be very famous in the matter of the hadith. There's some sahaba, they reported a few hadith. One of them is Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, if you read how many hadith, there's very few hadith. Umar ibn Khattab himself is a few hadith. You see? So, my point is, it's not, his description of Khattabi is weak. What is the term he says about the hadith? Sahih, hadith Hassan. Al-Tirmidhi. And also Al-Tirmidhi, there's a problem with his definition. Also Tirmidhi, but I want to know it. Why? Because I want to know, because I am studying science of the hadith. Science of the hadith. Believe me, this knowledge, the science of the hadith is so unique and beautiful. If you start to study and try to study each person in an individual and study his life story, you'll be amazed. You'll be amazed really. It makes you excited to learn more and more. Okay, he said Tirmidhi rahimahullah ta'ala, كل حديث يروى لا يكون في إسناده من يتهم بالكذب. Every hadith is reported, and in the chain of narration, no one accused to be a liar. No one is any hadith reported, but in the narration, no one was accused of lying. And it's not irregular, not chance, and reported in different ways. That of course, Jami' al-Tirmidhi, Mushrah al-Ahwadi, this term from al-Tirmidhi himself. This also description of the hadith is not really strong of hadith Hassan, not strong. Literally now, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. Who is Ibn Hajar? Write the name of Ibn Hajar, please. Write his name, because we're gonna mention Ibn Hajar a lot in the science of the hadith. We're gonna mention his name a lot. His name, Shihabuddin, his nickname, Shihabuddin. Nickname, not his name. His Shihabuddin. That means the Shihab, it is the Midwright of the Deen, Bright of the Deen, his nickname. But his name, Ahmed, write his name please. Ahmed Ibn Ali, what is that? Ibn Ali, Ibn Muhammad, Ibn Ali, Ibn Mahmoud, Ibn Ahmed, Ibn Hajar, Ibn Hajar, Al-Shafi'i, Al-Asqalani. You wrote it down? Again. Let me repeat it again, inshallah, his name. His name, his nickname, Shihab al-Din. Shihab al-Din. آمل بهم أحمد ابن علي ابن محمد ابن علي ابن محمود ابن أحمد ابن حجر هذا الشافعي المذهب تكون الطور شافعي العبقلاني العبقلاني إذا سيتي فارتاين سيتي فارتاين كرة عبقلان عبقلان إذا فلسطينيان فلسطينيان born in Cairo he born in Egypt in 773 he born in 773 هجرة and he died 862 that means 79 years he lived and is also the rank of the hadith his rank of the hadith الأمير المؤمنين أمير المؤمنين بالحديث الأمير المؤمنين بالحديث that he memorized around 100,000 حديث that means million حديث ما شاء الله and ابن حجر العسقلاني will be amazed and surprised and shocked amazed and surprised and shocked how many publications and how many books this man wrote. He'll be shocked. When Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih al-Bukhari, he explained all the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. And he called Fath al-Bari, Fath al-Bari, the book of Fath al-Bari, 37 volumes. 37 volumes in Bukhari. And he wrote about Rijal Hadith, the meaning of the Hadith. And he wrote about books. You cannot even imagine how many books this man wrote. Subhanallah. There is a barakah in this time. Barakah, blessing in this time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us barakah in our time. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us get benefits from our time. Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ameen. Okay, he said, and that's the beautiful meaning, his beautiful meaning in the hadith. He said, it is خبر الآحاد, of course, the meaning of hadith, الحسن, hadith حسن. See, خبر الآحاد, that means the news of the one person, Tony, one person, that means بنقل عدل كان الضبط. See, translate, transfer to us, came to us, with عدل that is just unfair and actually in memorization متصل السند connected by the chain of memorization and there is no defect and there is not irregular is not defect is not irregular and وهو صحيح لذاته and he is almost صحيح but لذاته Okay, honestly, this is one of the best of the meaning of the hadith. So, now, write down from the, all the, those I make for you meaning of the hadith sahih. And we're going to go to our book, of course. This is our book, we'll find some of it. Okay, from those hadith, I believe is that Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, one of the best of the terminology of the Hadith Hasan. Okay? Now, write down Hadith al-Hasan. Hadith al-Hasan. Similar like Hadith Sahih, but we have small things different. Small minor things different. Huwa mattasala sanadu, the chain of narration connected The chain of knowledge connected. Remember this, the hadith sahih too. Okay? بنقل العدل and reported by عدل that means just or just affair الذي خص ضبطه This is the only word different than the hadith sahih. خص that means the accuracy is not 100%. Hadith sahih is 100%. Hadith Hasan is not 100%. The accuracy is not accurate 100%. And عن مثله that is reported by also similar people, عدل ضابط. and there is not a regular or not the deficiency in it. Note it down. Okay. Shaitan is writing down this, I'm gonna send it to you right now. Okay, but let's go also to our book. ابن الصلاح رحمه الله سيد الحديث الحسن الذي ارتقى بكم الريفيد بمتابع او شاهد الريفيد وقد حديثه سيد هي صحيح لغيره it is صحيح because become like لغيره that لغيره because it is elevated by another hadith to become hadith صحيح and he said that is also hadith حسن called hadith حسن also right ابن الصلاح رحمه الله تعالى he give an example for us to understand it he said عن محمد بن عمرو بن علقمة ابن وقاص الليثي عن ابن أبي سلمة you don't have to write this down but it is in your book but I'm just trying to explain it he said لولا أشق that he said أبو هريرة reported by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said لولا أشق على أمتي لأمرتهم بالسواك عند كل صلاة if I oh, I don't want the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said I don't want to make it hard over my ummah the Muslims but because it's so I will order them to use the siwak for each salah to but our Prophet is not easy to find siwak now for example we're here in America and the siwak as even when we bought the siwak is not strong enough is not good enough so most of us will use a toothbrush most of us will so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if he want to make it hard over his ummah he will order them for each salah to use the siwak but he did not do that to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam okay okay what why are we making this hadith ابن الصلاح قال ابن الصلاح our author our book he said محمد بن عمرو the one who reported the hadith is the محمد بن عمرو صدوق صدوق but he is truthful حسن الحديث but he reported the hadith قطع حديث but his صدوق is not 100% bringing the his truthful person he is truthful he tried to do his best to bring the hadith the way he heard it from the تابعي from Abu Huraira right أتي محمد بن عمرو من المشهورين بالصدق والصيانة لكنه لم يكن من أهل الإتقان ابن الصلاح سيد محمد بن عمرو he is not he is a truthful man he is a good man and he brought the hadith but not accurate 100% he's not accurate 100% that's why his ahadith by the other ahadith similarly related to hadith Hasan that means we accept the hadith but because the other ahadith similar to this hadith sahiha so this specific hadith related to Hasan I know it's hard but believe me step by step we'll understand this more better inshallah And because of this hadith was, as I said, is reported by the other people that we say this hadith is hadith Hasan. All right. So, inshallah, the hadith Shad and Muhallal, this is part of the hadith Da'if, by the way. The hadith Da'if, the weak hadith. We're going to speak about the weak hadith. Which one weak we accept and which one weak we reject? Which one we reject and which one we accept? Inshallah. I want to stop here, inshallah. forgive me please, I'm not really feeling well. But I'll stop here. If you have any question, I'll take the question, inshallah, from you. Otherwise, we'll meet again next week, and we will send the email to you for the extra classes, inshallah. We're gonna send the email and the schedule for all of you. I'm talking about the Aris Institute students. The Aris students, we will send the schedule for you in order for you, inshallah, to know the extra classes we're gonna take, inshallah, from next week. Even the Rabbil Alameen. Please forgive me. I'm really not feeling well. I'm still in the hospital, as you see. I'm a bit in the hospital, and it's not easy for me. So just pray for me and make dua for me, inshallah. If you have any questions, please report the question and send the question to us in the email about the research paper and so on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase your knowledge, all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. And your families, inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you all. Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan da'ima wa qalban khashi'a wa yaqinan sabiqa wa ilman nafi'a wa ilman nafi'a wa ilman nafi'a. Allahumma inna nas'aluka dawam al-najati min kulli baliyah wa tamam al-afiyah wa al-shukr ala al-afiyah wa ridaka ya kareem. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم ارنا الحق حقا فارزقنا اتباعه وارنا الباطل باطلا فارزقنا اجتنابه ونور قلوبنا بالقران يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم زدنا علما اللهم زدنا علما اللهم زدنا علما وفقهنا في دينك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم فقهنا في دينك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم فقهنا في دينك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه.